Hello, and welcome back. I made 111 oil lamps in preparation for my next video. I'm going to attempt to have them all lit at the same time. I want to see how they look all burning together, along with how they sound as well. I'm using a glass wick design I came up with a few years ago. I couldn't find the right size of cotton wick to fit the vessel, so I attempted to make my own and discovered it can be done with glass. It uses what's called the capillary action, which happens in very narrow spaces and can draw liquids up against gravity. And so it's very dependent on the shape of the wick. And since the wicks are handmade, they all burn a little differently. Of course, they don't burn down themselves or melt closed as the rising heat lifts the flame off the tube. Although they still heat up quite a bit, so I would wait a couple minutes after the flame's extinguished before grabbing the wick. And now, as you can probably already hear, they do make a bit of noise. So it's going to be interesting to see what all 111 sound like. If you're new to this channel and curious about what can be found here, I mainly focus on flame working, which is glass blowing with a torch. I attempt a lot of different glass-related projects and incorporate some art and science along the way. And so if you want to learn the craft of glassworking yourself, or maybe just join me in this adventure, then hit the subscribe button. But make sure to share this video on your social feed so others can find it also. I've been working on it for over a month, and so not only has it been a bit of work, but it's taught me a bit more about how it works as well. I'll make sure to share those discoveries in my next video in 2 days for Father's Day. Subscribe so it'll pop up in your feed this Sunday. And it looks like I'm having some trouble with a couple wicks already. I didn't make that many extra either, so I might have to start moving some lamps around. The radiant heat from a stronger flame can keep a weaker wick alive. The lamp oil needs to maintain a certain temperature, called its flash point, in order to turn the combustible liquid into flammable vapor. The liquid itself isn't flammable. If you bring an open flame to a small pool of lamp oil, it won't ignite. It's a little different from alcohol, which has a flash point that's normally below room temperature, so it ignites readily. I'll have a demonstration of that in my next video, so you don't have to try it at home. Just wait and see. And now, if you have any questions, comments, or just want to say hi, you can leave that down in the comment section below. And so this is taking a lot longer to light than I originally imagined it would. The main point was actually just for a cover photo on my next video. But it's taking so long, it's practically a video in itself. These days on YouTube, it can be a bit difficult to have your videos found by an audience. I have to spend the extra time to make more attractive or elaborate cover photos. But in the end, as long as you're spending the time to enjoy my work, then I'll spend the time to keep making it. A few of the projects that I'm planning for this year, one would be a fire pit in my backyard. I'm planning to build it mostly out of brick and possibly recess it into the ground a little bit. But then to give it a glassy touch, I plan to install some glass around the outside. I'm hoping it will bend and refract the light from the flame in possibly some cool and unique ways. It's going to take some experimentation. But that's a lot of what this channel is about. Like experimenting with electricity. I'll be making a larger hand crank generator in order to power some small devices. It has taken me a little bit of time to better understand electronics, but hopefully one day I'll be harnessing the power of lightning itself in a bottle. Now, if only I can harness better aim. I'm gonna attempt a project which my viewers recommended against for safety. But the gears have already started rolling, so I'm gonna have to just play it extra safe when I attempt to shoot glass arrows. I was mainly worried about the weight and spine of the glass arrow. That's flexibility. It's actually looking close to a normal arrow. Maybe a little more heavy and stiff, but it should fly. Now the fear is it might explode coming off the bow. But I'm not one to throw caution to the wind, so I'll be plenty prepared. I'll have to construct a target. And if I do that, I might as well do throwing knives also. I actually did throwing stars, glass shurikens, around this time last year. But I didn't have a large target, so I couldn't really practice before attempting it on camera. So get ready for some glass sports-related fun before the year is done. Besides that, I do plan to get some items up on my Etsy page. It's Jasa Glass, J-A-S-A Glass. So I'm hoping to have a small handful of items before the year's out. Nothing's up there yet. It's one of those things I have to test out a bit to get into the groove. I mostly do different wearables or little glass trinkets. But I'm not sure about this oil lamp. I'll talk more about that on Sunday. And now, if you've been watching all along as I've been lighting these, you're an awesome viewer. I'm not just saying that to be nice. I say it considering how loud these candles have gotten. It kind of sounds like a large swarm of bees to me. Or maybe some rushing water, like a waterfall. So I can't imagine a lot of people would watch this entire video. And I'm not going to filter it either. I want you to have the full experience of all 111 candles. At the end, I'll go around with the camera to give you more perspective, along with a close-up so they look very giant. Perspective is very important in life as well. You have to always look at things from more than one angle, which is difficult being stuck in one place. But what might look like a bit of a chaotic mess, similar to these oil lamps, may prove to be more orderly when observed through a different perspective. And something that may seem orderly might actually be a bit chaotic, like some of these troublesome wicks. Also, in the beginning, I was having some difficulty seeing because it wasn't bright enough. Now I'm having trouble because it's too bright. And again, if you're still with me here and enjoying the video, that's really awesome. We're about to reach the maximum volume, so it won't get any louder after that. Minus for the moment when I'm zooming in and going around the candles. And lastly, I just want to say thank you for watching. Make sure to subscribe and share the video. That definitely helps me out a lot. Also, enjoy your weekend. Don't forget to stay well hydrated in this heat. And now with the last of the candles lit, I will finish the video in silence. Stay melty, my friends.